আলহামদুলিল্লাহ, আলহামদুলিল্লাহ রাব্বিল আলামিন ওয়া আকিবাতুল মুত্তাকিন ওয়া সালাতু ওয়া সালামু আলা সাইয়্যিদিল আম্বিয়া ওয়াল মুরসালিন ওয়া আলা আলিহি ওয়া আসহাবিহি আজমাইন। আম্মা বাদ, ইন দ্য নেম অফ আল্লাহ দি মোস্ট বেনিফিশিয়েন্ট দি মোস্ট মার্সিফুল, আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়া রাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়া বারাকাতুহু। মে দ্য পিস, মার্সি, ব্লেসিংস অফ আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা বি আপন অল অফ ইউ মাই ব্রাদার্স এন্ড সিস্টার্স। We praise Allah and we thank Allah once again. He has given us this opportunity to remind ourselves about the beautiful teachings of the Quran, to remind ourselves about the beautiful teachings of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So inshallah, today is the 8th of Muharram, and this Sunday will be the 10th of Muharram inshallah, the day of the Ashura. And we know that on 10th of Muharram, it is highly recommended to fast for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. And 10th of Muharram, this Sunday, is a very special day, is a very important day, very sacred day in the sight of Allah and in the sight of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And for this reason, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that hadha yawmun min ayyamillah aw kama qala alaihi wasallam, that this day of the Ashura, this 10th of Muharram, is subhanallah, is from the days that are dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 10th of Muharram is from the days which are dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means that in these days we should engage ourselves in extra worship, in extra ibadah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to ask His forgiveness, to make the tawbah in His presence, and to make the istighfar. And it is highly recommended to fast, as I have mentioned, on this 10th of Muharram. And there is a lot of importance, a lot of significance. One hadith I want to mention concerning to this, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the fasting on the 10th of Muharram, yukaffiru sanat al-madiyah, this fasting on the 10th of Muharram, it expiates the sins of the past year. It expiates the sins of the previous year. All the sins that you have committed, minor sins we're talking about, minor sins from last 2019 till 2020, from last 41 Muharram till this 10th of Muharram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all of our sins. Minor sins. And when it comes to the major sins will be only forgiven when we will make the sincere tawbah in the presence of Allah. So let us not deprive ourselves from this great sa'adah, from this great blessing, from this opportunity to get rid from all our minor sins of year, just fasting on one day, on the 10th of Muharram, which is this Sunday, inshallahul aziz. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam also mentioned, narrated by Hazrat Umar Hazrat Abdullah bin Umar ibn al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that whoever fasts on the day of the Ashura, which is the 10th of Muharram, it is as if he has fasted the entire year. Subhanallah. Allah will bless us with the reward of fasting the entire year just by fasting on the 10th of Muharram. And the next virtuous action that we can do on this very special day, this Sunday inshallah, is what? Is giving the charity, spending the wealth and spending the money on your family, on your loved ones, on your community, on the needy, on the people, on the destitute, on the less fortunate, is to giving the charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that whoever gives the charity this day on the 10th of Muharram, it is like the charity of an entire year. Charity of an entire year, subhanallah. This is what my Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And it is also narrated, transmitted by Imam Bahaiqi, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that one who generously spend on his family on the day of the Ashura, subhanallah, Allah will be generous on him for the entire year. For the entire year, subhanallah. If you are spending on your family or on your community, on the needy, on the poor, on the destitute, Allah will spend on you entire year. Spending, Allah, what does it mean? Allah will protect you, Allah will guard you, Allah will guide you, Allah will shower His blessings upon you. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself said, Hadith Qudsi, Ya Ibn Adam, Anfiq Alika, O the son of Adam, I will spend on you, subhanallah. So when you will spend on this day, in this day on your family, Allah will spend on you in the entire year, inshallah al-Aziz. And Sufyan bin Uyayna, it is mentioned by him that he says that I have practiced this, means that this call of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this saying of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he says, if you spend in your family on the 10th of Muharram, Allah will spend on you in the entire year. Sufyan bin Uyayna, he mentions that I have practiced this hadith, I have implemented this hadith in my life for 60 years, and I have found nothing but good in it. May that Allah was keep spending on me, Allah was keep blessing me, Allah was keep protecting me and keep guiding me, just because I was very generous and I was very kind and merciful with my family, especially on this day, on the 10th of Muharram. It doesn't mean that only spend on your family on the 10th of Muharram, other days as well, but on this day, extra. This is a very special day in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we know that we should fast on this day, 10th of Muharram, which is this Sunday. We should give the sadaqah, we should give the charity, inshallah. And we should make the istighfar as well. The third thing that you can do on this day is to make the istighfar. Why? Because there are multiple narrations, many narrations, which was quoted by the mufassireen, by the muhaddiseen, by the sahaba ikram, that the tawbah of Nabi Adam alayhi wasalam, the repentance of Adam alayhi wasalam was accepted on the 10th of Muharram. Imam Tibrani, Imam Baihaqi, a lot of classical scholars, predecessors, they mentioned that the tawbah of Adam alayhi wasalam was accepted on the day of the Ashura actually. Subhanallah. And it was on this day that the Ark of Nuh alayhi wasalam came to rest on the Mount Judi or Judi. Subhanallah. On this day. And Subhanallah. So the third thing that you can do is to ask Allah's forgiveness, make the istighfar, and through the barakat of this blessed day, Allah will accept our forgiveness, because this is the day that many prophets, they passed away on this day, they born on this day as well. Subhanallah. And one of the reasons that we are recommended and we are instructed and we are encouraged to fast on the 10th of Muharram is when Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he migrated from Makkah to Medina, so he witnessed, he noticed that the Jews, the people of Jews, they were fasting on the 10th of Muharram. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked to them, Ibn Abbas narrated this, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them, inquired from them, that from the Jews, that ma hadhal yawm alladhi tasumunahu, that what is this day that you are fasting? Mizr, what is the reason behind your fasting on the 10th of Muharram? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is asking the Jews. Now they are replying to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that hadha yawmun azimun, that this is the great day, this is the righteous day in our calendar, in our life. Why? Because this is the day anjallahu fihi Musa wa qawmuhu. This is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Moses and his qawm, his entire nation, his entire community from the clutches of the tyrant ruler, Pharaoh, the Firaun, from the oppression of the Pharaoh. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved us and saved Musa from the Pharaoh on the 10th of Muharram. And Allah drowned him, means that the Pharaoh, Allah drowned the Pharaoh and his entire army on the 10th of Muharram. And for this reason, فَصَامَهُ مُوسَى شُكْرًا فَنَحْنُ نَسُومُنَهُ, and for this reason, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Moses, he kept the fast, you know, as a thanksgiving, as a expression of gratitude in the presence of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved them and his entire nation from the tyrant ruler, the Pharaoh. So for this reason, we also keep the fast as thanking Allah, praising Allah for giving us this blessing, for giving us this bounty. And then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon hearing this, he says that فَنَحْنُ أَحَقُّ وَأَوْلَى بِمُوسَى مِنْكُمْ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ سَتُ وَسَلَامُ. He says, if this is the case, we are more deserving and more closer to Musa than you. We are more deserving to fast on this day. We are more deserving to thank Allah. And we love Musa more than you. We love Prophet Musa more than you. So that is why for this reason we are also going to fast. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam fasted on this day, and he instructed his sahaba, his companion, to fast on the 10th of Muharram, to follow and to follow the practice of Musa alayhi wasalam, the sunnah of Musa alayhi wasalam. And it was even on the 10th of Muharram, actually, it was fasted even by Ibrahim alayhi wasalam. And for your information, and many of us, we are aware of this, that the fasting on the 10th of Muharram was obligatory. It was not optional. Even in the time of the Jahiliyyah, in the time of the ignorance, in the time of the darkness, means that even before the advent of Islam, people of Quraysh, people of Makkah, people of Arab, they used to fast on the 10th of Muharram, following the footsteps of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi wasalam. He even used to fast on the 10th of Muharram. Subhanallah. So, but later on, subhanallah, the obligation to fast on the 10th of Muharram was transferred to the fasting of the month of Ramadan. So the fasting of Ramadan became obligatory, in which Allah Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba alalladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. And the fasting on the 10th of Muharram became the optional. But it is highly recommended to fast. It is highly recommended to fast. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast. Good. And I also want to mention with that there are multiple narrations in which Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that he showed his desire and he instructed his sahaba to keep extra fast with the 10th of Muharram, with the day of the Ashura, or to join the fasting of the Ashura with the next day, with the 9th or with the 11th of Muharram. This is what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that if I live until the next year, I will certainly fast the 9th day of the Muharram, the day of the 9th day of the month of Muharram. But Allah willed something else and he departed this dunya before the next Muharram. For this reason, Sahaba Ikram and the scholars, they mentioned that it is highly recommended to join the fasting of the 10th of Muharram with 9th or with 11th. So you have two options. You can fast either on 9th and 10th of Muharram or 10th and 11th of Muharram, inshallah. And this is the best option to fast on the 10th, on the days of the Ashura, on the day of the Ashura. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and to guide us and to forgive us. And Imam Ibn Hajar Asqalani, rahimahullah, he mentions that there are three maratib, there are three levels of the fasting of Ashura. One level of the fasting of Ashura is what? Just to fast on the 10th of Muharram. Even if you're fasting on the 10th of Muharram, you will still get the reward. You will not be sinful. If you can't fast because of any circumstances, because of anything, even if you're fasting on the 10th of Muharram, you should better do it because of its importance, because of its significance. This is the first level of the Ashura, the day of the Ashura, the fasting of the day of the Ashura. And what is the second? Second is to either fast 9th, 10th, or 10th, 11th. This is the second. And the third, which is best among all these three categories, and that is to fast 9th, 10th, and 11th. 3 days. 3 days of fasting. This is also recommended. So we should fast tomorrow, inshallah, which is Saturday. We should fast Sunday as well, and we should fast Monday. Subhanallah, Monday is always the best day because Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast on Monday. Every Monday he used to fast because Allah, you know, subhanallah, blessed him with a lot of blessings on the day of the Monday. So you can do this, inshallah. This is my intention, and make your intention. I encourage you to make this intention, inshallah, to fast Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Or if you can't fast these 3 days, at least fast Saturday and Sunday, or Sunday and Monday, or just Sunday, inshallah. Allah is merciful. Allah will still give us the complete reward, inshallah. Remember, it is only optional. It is highly recommended. And even if you don't even fast on the 10th of Muharram, you will not be sinful. But I will encourage you, I will recommend you to fast as the Sahaba did, as Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, recommended us to fast on the 10th of Muharram, inshallah. And we know that on the 10th of Muharram, one of the most important events happened, and there is a tragedy of Karbala. That is one of the most important that could have happened in the month of Ramadan, in the month of Rabiul Awal. But Allah has chosen 10th of Muharram for the martyrdom of Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu. It shows the importance of this shahada. It shows the importance of this martyrdom. That he passed away from this dunya, you know, on the 10th of Muharram, which is the day of the repentance, which is the day of the celebration of the Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his entire nation. All the many other anbiya, many other prophets. So subhanallah, so we remind ourselves about their tragedy as well, and that is why I have started the Karbala series. Inshallah, it will continue even after the month of Muharram. Allah knows better. So inshallah, tonight you can join me once again 7 p.m. on San Fernando Jama Masjid Facebook page for the fourth episode, for the fourth session of Karbala series. I will be talking about today, inshallah, about the next member of the family of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the another member of the family of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was known as Hazrat Ali al-Murtada radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, one of the caliph of Islam, fourth caliph of Islam, who took over from Usman bin Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. So it's important to educate yourself and ourselves about these great nufus, about these great souls, about these great personalities and individuals. It helps us to increase our iman, it helps us to increase our faith. And I just want to share one call, one saying of Imam Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the great sahabi of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I will even mention, inshallah, this evening. He mentions concerning to the patience. Hazrat Ali al-Murtada radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that verily patience is to the faith as the head is to the body. Verily patience is to the faith as the head is to the body. In other words, that the importance of patience in Islam, the importance of sabr in Iman and in faith is as the importance of head to the entire body. And then he mentions that if you cut the head, the entire body will perish. So in other words, if you will remove the sabr, if you will remove the patience from your Iman, from your faith, from your Islam, you will not be able to achieve and acquire the true halawa of Iman, the true sweetness of Iman. You will not succeed in every single step of your life if you don't have this beautiful quality of patience, this beautiful quality of sabr. And for this reason, he mentions that ala innahu la imana liman la sabr lahu. No doubt there is no faith for one without patience. No faith without patience. Patience is incumbent. Patience is important in the life of a Muslim. Patience is very vital in a life of a believer. That is why, for this reason, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ista'inu, O you believers, ask my help. Look for my help. Beg for my help. If you really want me to help you, then do two things. Two things. First is sabr and salah. Ask my help, ask my assistance with patience and with the salah. Patience is important. Very, very important. So that is why this is just one of his call, one of his saying that I thought I should share with you, inshallah. More things, I will talk, few things, inshallah. Not much this evening. 20 to 25 minutes, inshallah. You can join me 7 p.m. on San Fernando Jam Masjid Facebook page, inshallah. So, good. So, inshallah, we should encourage ourselves to fast tomorrow. Tomorrow is the 9th of Muharram, Saturday. And Sunday will be the 10th of Muharram, inshallah. Make the dua, make the istighfar, give the charity, give the sadaqah, keep the fast. Offer 5 salat. You should offer, we should offer, we must offer actually. It's obligatory 5 salat every single day. But on the 10th of Muharram, offer non-obligatory prayers as well. Offer the nawafil as well, inshallah. Recite the Quran, make the zikr of Allah. Say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Send durud on Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Send durud on the al of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on the martyrdom of on the martyrs of Karbala, and educate yourself and remind yourself about the beautiful teachings of Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for us in every single step of our life. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. So inshallah, Imam Sahib, Imam Adam Barachia, he's our assistant Imam. If you can come forward and call the azan. And then afterwards, inshallah, you can offer the Salatul Zuhur, inshallah, in your homes. Or even if you have performed Salatul Zuhur already, that is okay. This is just for the blessing. That's all.
Take your time and call us. It is on television. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'alas salah, hayya 'alas salah, hayya 'alal falah. Hayya alal falah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, Ali Zati Azim Sifati Kabir Shani Jalil Qadri Rafi'i Zikr Jalil Burhan Sari Al Hisabi Shadid Al Iqabi Aziz Sultan Wa Nashhadu An La Ilaha Illallah Wahdahu La Sharika Lah ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. أما بعد، فيا أيها الناس وحدوا الله فإن التوحيد رأس الطاعات، واتقوا الله فإن التقوى ملاك الحسنات، وعليكم بالسنة فإن السنة تهدي إلى الإطاعة، ومن أطاع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى، وعليكم بالإحسان فإن الله يحب المحسنين، ولا تقنطوا من رحمة الله فإنه أرحم الراحمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم، إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين، واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم صل. الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. قال الله عز وجل في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. وقال، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وقال، واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا. وقال، إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وعز وجل وعظم وأكبر.